So you might think you know the shape builder tool and what it's used for, but I'm going to show you the settings, where they are, and how to use them. If you want the chance to enter into a free 5-week course based around how to set up and run an online agency or a business, Template Monster is giving you that very chance totally for free. So learn more about that later in today's video. For those who don't know what the Shape Builder tool is and how to use it, let's quickly take a look. The Shape Builder tool is essentially used for combining shapes together to make new shapes. This is great for logo design and icon design and so forth. And you can find the Shape Builder tool over here. You will notice the keyboard shortcut is Shift and M. And if you hold down a click, you can access the other tools in this category. Now, to actually use the Shape Builder tool, you need to have your selection of objects highlighted. And then once you've done that, you can then press the keyboard shortcut to access the Shape Builder tool. So by default, it's in merge mode, which means there's a plus icon around the cursor, and this would allow you to unite shapes together. If you hold down the Alt or the Option key, this will take you into subtract mode, which means you will remove and erase parts of the objects. So obviously, in merge mode, I click and drag to highlight and merge together certain sections of my group. And then of course, holding down the Alt or the Option key, we head into subtract mode when I can erase certain parts of my design. And then when ready, I can press V for the selection tool, and then press Shift and X to flick the shape over to a filled object. So that's the basics, but there actually are some options for the Shape Builder tool. And if you come into the window drop-down menu, you won't find anything there, or at least I don't think there is anything there. But what you do need to do, you need to come over to the Shape Builder tool in the toolbar, and then double-click the tool itself. So this brings up a few options, which I'm going to discuss and go through in the video coming right up. So the first and a somewhat interesting option is that we have the ability to discard any breaks in the path of a shape and actually think of it as one united shape, even though it's got a break in it somewhere. So I'm going to cut up this shape by using the scissors tool, which is C on the keyboard. And if I remove this part of the shape, it's now not a closed path shape, there's a break in it. And I'm going to use points as a measurement because in the settings, it dictates the size of the gap according to points. Now this is pretty tricky and it takes some guesswork sometimes. The highest value you can use is 72 points. So having this setting checked and activated will allow Illustrator to treat each shape with a break in it as a closed path. So as you can see here, this path is broken, but Illustrator still thinks of it as a closed path. This is handy for digital illustrations and things like that. And obviously when I deselect this option, Illustrator doesn't recognize it as a closed path anymore. So next, we're going to look at a setting that will allow you to split stroke paths when you're using the merge mode. With this selection of shapes here, I'm going to show you how to do that. So again, double click the Shape Builder tool, and then you're going to notice this in merge clicking stroke split path option. When we use this mode, it essentially means we can split a stroke of a shape where it meets another shape. This is really handy for working with line art or line designs or stroke designs. So as you can see, I've clicked the circle in two areas with the red line indicating this. And then when I come to use the selection tool, you will see I've actually split this shape up into two shapes where they intersect with the square. Again, this is a really handy and a pretty useful setting to know with the Shape Builder tool. Next, we're going to look at the kind of selection method, and I will address the color swatches and also the filled path later. But for now, this next setting is pretty redundant if you ask me. if you choose the straight line selection method, whatever you want to use and select with your groups of shapes, you can only use a straight line cursor. Now, literally, I've never found a use for this option and I've never used it. I always use the freeform option, which means I have complete freedom where I want to unite and select my shapes. The highlight options here are just basically user interface settings for the colors and whatever else, showing you what you're doing when you're using the shape builder tool. But let's go back up and let's check out this consider open field paths as closed. And this really is like it sounds. If you have a shape with a break in it like we had earlier, but the shape has a fill, Illustrator is going to see that shape as being closed no matter how large the gap is when it's got a color fill. So I have two squares here and you can see a huge gap in this blue square. And with this setting activated, you can see Illustrator does see it as a closed path, which is really, really useful. And for the last setting, as you see, I've just selected this shape. It's used my swatches in the left as a guide to color the artwork. But if I actually change the setting to color using the original artwork, you will notice it leaves with a stroke and a blue fill. So, as I mentioned at the start of the video, Template Monster is holding one of their awesome and handy marathons. What is a marathon, you might ask, in terms of design and business running? I'm not talking about jogging here. A marathon on Template Monster is a 6-week crash course on running an online business or agency totally for free. Each week, you're going to be given a course, and at the end of the week, a Template Monster mentor will decide if you can excel to the next phase, ending on the 5th and the final week, where you would have learned how to set up an online agency to gain clients, negotiate with clients, and much, much more. And again, this is totally for free. You only have until the 11th of June to sign up, so do hurry up and click the link in the description box below if you want to grab this prime opportunity. So there was the rundown on the Shape Builder tool and the hidden settings. Let me know if you learned something today and if you knew about these settings. Also, if you want to keep learning about graphic design, expanding your skills and your awareness as a designer, subscribe to my channel for weekly graphic design content. Have a great day, and until next time, design your future today. Peace.